إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجاها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا والنساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطيع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد We begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we seek refuge from the evil that is within our own selves and the evil that is found within our actions. We testify and bear witness to the fact that nothing is worthy of worship except Allah. He is alone and He has no partners. And we bear witness to the fact that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is His slave and final messenger. To proceed, brothers and sisters, we are very happy to be, alhamdulillah, in Toronto, Canada. It is a blessing. It is our first time to be in such a community in events such as this one on our second visit ever to Canada. And we're coming from the city of Houston, Texas, alhamdulillah, below Canada from the United States. Brothers and sisters, today's khutbah is entitled, Why Are Latinos Becoming Muslim? This is a question that arises wherever we may travel. And I would like to take this time or this day of Yom Jumu'ah, the day of remembrance, to be able to look at ourselves first and foremost and ask ourselves how we have been gifted this deen and what it is that we're doing about it. And we hope, inshallah, that in contemplating a few words that I will share, inshallah, in the following 20 minutes or so, that we reflect upon ourselves, inshallah, and that we're able to leave this place reminded of our duty to Allah Azza wa Jal and being thankful to Him alone. 3 months before September 11th, in a community in Houston, Texas, in a mosque, there was a 57-year-old man in the back sitting with a 23-year-old young man. And in the front of this mosque were people of knowledge such as Sheikh Yasser Qadhi when he was studying in Medina University, Sheikh Muhammad al-Sharif, who had not yet launched what went to become Al-Maghrib Institute, and other people of knowledge were sitting in the front speaking 3 months before September 11th. They noticed that the young man in the back kept talking to the 57-year-old man. And so it was Sheikh Muhammad al-Sharif that asked to please not speak to this young man and the other gentleman. And the young man told them, he doesn't know English, so I'm translating for him. When they realized that their talk was being translated from Spanish to English, they continued. The interruption of the shuyukh, they maybe were not aware of the fact that the city of Houston, Texas is 44% Latino. Some of them coming from outside of the city. But they continued and they let the speech go on. The 57-year-old man turned to the young man after a while of understanding what was being said. From Islam, he turned to him and he said, the speech of these people should be the speech of the leaders of the world. And we know, brothers and sisters, that from Allah's book, Allah Azza wa Jal tells us, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jal mentions rhetorically, and who's better in speech? Who is better in the way that they communicate, that they speak, than the one who invites to the way of Allah while doing righteous deeds? Meaning that what they say is what they do. And on top of that, they say or they proclaim without any doubt, I'm amongst those who submit, or I am a Muslim. When people live in this way and they give information and they explain and educate others about Islam, it has an impact on someone. Even if they're from another background, even if this person never heard about Islam, even if they don't know the language that's being spoken. Going back to the story, the young man asked the 57-year-old man, what is it from what you've heard that you don't like about Islam so far? 57-year-old man replied and he said, there's something unique or different about this from all the other religions that I've seen in my life. In every religion, I have had an issue with the fact that the followers of that religion don't do what their religion says. But there's something different that I'm hearing here. There is a man whose example still lives on as an example to be followed. He was referring to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, if this man actually lived out the theory of this religion and it's still maintained and preserved, this is something different that I haven't seen from any other religion. If that's the case, then the people who follow that could actually follow the message. And he mentioned, that's the issue that I've had. I don't want to follow people. I don't want to follow human beings. I've just been seeking to understand the true God and know how to follow Him. This is one of the unique things about Islam, brothers and sisters, that sometimes people who have been born in Islam maybe have not realized that there is a ni'mah, there is a blessing, a barakah, to even know of the existence of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, let alone our responsibility to him and the love that is due to him in order that we may be able to benefit. As Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in his book, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jal mentions directly to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we have not sent you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, except as a mercy for all of mankind. And all of the jinn and anything that has a choice. See, brothers and sisters, when we're not Muslim, we look at this life as everything. Either you get it and you amass it and you run after it and obtain it, or you lose. That's why so many people's philosophy of life is, there's only one life, you gotta live it to the fullest, and you basically run behind whatever it is that your desire leads you to do. There's really no rules. It's just a matter of looking out for oneself and amassing things. The Prophet ﷺ has been sent as a mercy to mankind, but people who don't know that he was sent as a mercy to mankind, people who don't know of his existence and his message, they're not receiving the mercy. They don't have it. They can't access it. The young man turned to the 57-year-old man and asked, if everything you've heard about Islam you don't have any issue with, then why not accept it? The 57-year-old man said, I don't see why not. Brothers and sisters, this story happened almost 19 years ago. And that is the story of my father and myself. in the city of Houston, Texas. I had just embraced Islam 3 months prior. And when we become Muslim, we're challenged because we have to go back to our family members and explain why we even accepted Islam to begin with. Our own family who have known us and they know how we operate and how we think, when they begin to see the changes take place. I grew up in a neighborhood where back in the early 90s, there were gangs, there were drugs, there were people who had been shot. Young friends of mine didn't make it to school after 1 weekend. I lived in an environment where you had to survive, where you didn't go home and tell your parents what you went through because they wouldn't understand, we thought. To then all of a sudden become a Muslim and not drink alcohol, not go out to clubs, not do so many of the things that we grew up doing, the only thing left for my mother to say is, you've joined a cult. You are with a group of people who have washed your brain, and I'm scared for you. And I told my mother, if all my life as a young man growing up, you told me, stop going out, don't get in trouble, don't drink, the day that I do it, and I say it's because I chose to submit to one God, then I'm crazy all of a sudden. I don't understand that. So my father was the first person to say, let me go with you to these people and find out what it is that you found out. And after his questioning and researching, he came to this conclusion, brothers and sisters, that day. And as soon as I got up, I came up to Sheikh Yasir Qadhi and I said, my father wants to become Muslim. Can you please give him Shahada? See, we don't know the etiquette of the Muslims. We don't know if interrupting somebody while they're talking is an issue because they're talking, you know, between Maghrib and Isha, and the Muslims have these systems that they do things and they've been doing them a certain way, and everybody comes, sits on the floor, takes off their shoes. All of these things, a person from society doesn't understand it. So all I knew is, I don't want to delay this. If he already made up his mind, I came and I asked him, can you please give my father Shahada? And he stopped in the middle of the talk and he gave me a microphone like this and he said, you give your father Shahada. And I asked my dad to come up, and it may have been the first time in that community that the people saw and heard an individual who was from the Latino community bearing witness to the Shahada in the Arabic language and saying, a testigo que nada merece ser adorado excepto Allah y a testigo que Muhammad es su mensajero. Brothers and sisters, that statement, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, is the statement that takes somebody from darkness into light. You know, so many of the youth who grew up, in the time that I grew up, they may have passed away from a drive-by shooting. I was standing in a corner one day when I was 16 years old, and a car drove by and they shot, and I had just walked away from that place 15 minutes earlier. One of my friends lost his right eye from a shotgun blast. Two other people were injured. The day we embrace Islam, we go back in time and say, wow, Allah was in control and He knew all things. But people who didn't make it to the age of 23, such as myself, at that moment of being a Muslim, they never even heard the testimony of faith in their life. How many of us as Muslims say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, even when we're making salah, and we're not thinking about the implication of what that means? How many of us realize that having this testimony of faith ingrained in your heart since you were a kid because your parents told you? How many of you realize that walking in society, you have a light that people are looking for and they don't even know exists? You know, when I became Muslim, I just felt like my father needed to know, my mother needed to know, right? My family members need to know about this, but they asked the question, If there are Muslims living here in society, where Houston, mashallah, has over 100 masajid, the city that I live has over 100 masajid, more than 150,000, some say more than 200,000 Muslims, they ask the question, how come I never heard about it? And I had no answer. But one thing that I do know, brothers and sisters, is that the language is a vehicle of communication that Allah Azza wa Jal has used in order to communicate His message to people who understand life based on their own culture, their own symbols. The colors of every culture mean different things. Words means different things. Traditions means different things. And Allah Azza wa Jal has chosen people to speak in a specific language in order to go back to their people and deliver the message in their language, within their cultural context. As Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in His book, in Surah Ibrahim, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِهِ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَهُمْ وَيُدِلُّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَهْدِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. Allah Azza wa Jal mentions, and I have not sent a messenger except that he spoke the language of his people in order to make the message clear for them. Then Allah guides whomsoever He wills and leaves astray whomsoever He wills. And He is the Almighty, the All-Wise. May Allah Azza wa Jal guide us to understand our unique reality and ability in whatever language we speak, that we go back to our people and that we be examples following in the footsteps of the Prophet ﷺ and understanding Tawheed, the oneness of Allah, in our thoughts and our actions. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik wa ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala, amma ba'd. So brothers and sisters, now that you heard the story of how we went on to embrace Islam 3 months before September 11th, my father became Muslim. As you heard in the beginning of the khutbah, one day he turned to me and he said, how come there's no material in Spanish? After September 11th, people were asking for material in the Spanish language. Houston's 44% Latino. 150,200 Muslims, and there was no material in Spanish. So the Muslim community asked me after September 11th to speak in front of the media, Univision, CNN in Spanish, Telemundo, to talk in the Spanish language, to talk to the general society about what we found out about Islam. Because what we found in Islam, from the Quran and the Sunnah, from the sources, we didn't see that being represented in the media. What was being shown in the media was totally different than what we found. And as we were running away from our lifestyle of how we grew up in our neighborhood to something that gave guidance, people were thinking that Islam was what we were seeing in our neighborhoods, the violence and all of these issues. So my father turned to me one day and he said, you know, you should learn media so that you can produce media in order to be able to disseminate the message in the Spanish language. And he said, if I don't have material in Spanish, how am I going to learn Islam? You should do it. So alhamdulillah, we went and studied multimedia and film. And my father used his voice to be able to read the entire Spanish Quran, and we recorded it in audiobooks. You know, Riyadh al-Salihin is a way to understand the Sunnah in a simplistic manner. Alhamdulillah, we finished all of Riyadh al-Salihin in the Spanish language. 40 hadith and Nawawi, principles of this deen. All of these Islamic works that for so many generations have been done and had not been produced in a professional manner in Spanish, it was my father who pushed me to do that. I was just a young man. But he said, there's so many other people that could benefit from this. And alhamdulillah, we went on to establish an organization called Islam in Spanish. Islam in the Spanish language, following the Sunnah of Allah Azza wa Jal, that He sent people to speak in their language. And alhamdulillah, it is the leading organization worldwide producing media. And we recently, in the city of Houston, Texas, went back to our neighborhood where we were not part of doing the good as we grew up. We went back to fix whatever was broken, and alhamdulillah, Allah blessed us to purchase a 2-acre property 3 minutes away from the high school that we went to. The second day of Ramadan this year, alhamdulillah, we closed on that property. We have a 10,000 square foot facility there. And previous to this, we rented a place that had never come together, led by Latino Muslims. And alhamdulillah, we witnessed around 200 people embrace Islam. This past week, brothers and sisters, we had the opportunity to purchase 1/2 acre of land next door. And today, as I'm standing here, at the same time, Imam Isa Parada, a brother who graduated from Medina University, who is Salvadorian, he's given a khutbah outside of Houston, and we're giving a khutbah here. And I mentioned to Imam Isa, wherever we give a khutbah, we let the Muslims know that these two, this 1/2 acre of property, alhamdulillah, we have to close on it in a month. The 24th, in less than a month. 24th of February, we have to close on it. I told him, I said, tell the people over there, see if they will give 30,000, which is half of what is due, and I'll tell the people wherever I go, 30,000. We didn't know it would be here in Canada. But alhamdulillah, on your way out, brothers and sisters, be sure you go by the table. We have audio, video material so that you too can share it with people around this area who speak the Spanish language. And tonight we have an open house, alhamdulillah, in the Dawah Center here in downtown. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us a means to be able to be ambassadors of this deen of Islam. May Allah help us and guide us to work together and admit our human limitations, but remember Allah's greatness and work with our skills that He gave us to use for His sake. May Allah Azza wa Jal guide and protect us as individuals and our families and our communities. May Allah Azza wa Jal bless us to work with brothers and sisters and collaborate for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. May Allah protect us from showing off and doing things to please others besides Allah, and that we strive to serve humanity at large while we celebrate our common humanity based on the Quran and the Sunnah. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد